what he healed on today. And we want to give him glory. Hallelujah. For he is due his glory. We talk about due praise. Because he's due his praise. Hallelujah. Y'all heard me say this before. It's only two times that we need to praise the Lord. When we feel like it and when we don't. So that is not an excuse. Amen. But we just gonna give God glory on today because he's good. He brought us a mighty long way. You've heard the report. It's been some who didn't make it. They took their own lives, had fame and fortune, but they left the planet. But we are still here because God said it. Why? Because we're clothed and in our right mind. And he saw fit for us to be here. Hallelujah. We just want to give him glory. I had a song. It left me. Lord, bring that song back to me. I'm thinking
about
my... What is that song? It was there. It was there.
Stop by here, Lord. Stop by here.
Stop by here. Oh, Lord, stop by here. Grace and mercy, Lord God, you are awesome in our eyesight, oh God, and we come before an awesome God with awesome praise, oh God. Lord God, we exalt your holy name, oh God. Father, we just give our all to you on today, Lord God, and Lord God, we just yield ourselves, oh God. We avail ourselves, oh God. Let this be what you would have it to be, oh God. Lord God, we thank you for the unusual, oh God. We praise you for the miraculous, oh God. Father, we thank you for your healing virtue on today, oh God. Regulate some thoughts, oh God. Father, that we would ourselves so that you could fill us again, oh God. Lord God, we just ask for a mighty stirring in this house, oh God. A mighty stirring in our very spirit, man, God. Lord God, we desire to sup with you, oh God. To commune with you, oh God. To learn more about you, oh God. Lord God, we thank you, Lord God, for you have been so faithful, God. Father, you brought us to such a time as this, oh God. And Lord God, you are a spirit. And they that worship you must worship you in spirit and in truth, oh God. Let no flesh glory in your presence, oh God. Father, that this will continually be a spirit-filled atmosphere, oh God. Father, as you begin to shift our days, oh God, shift our memories, oh God, shift our histories, oh God. Father, we are pressing toward the mark of the high calling in Christ Jesus, oh God. Father, we're forgetting those things of old, oh God. And Lord, we are beholding those things which are new, oh God. Lord God, I thank you for pouring out your mercy, oh God. For pouring out your grace, oh God. Father, we thank you that this ground is holy ground, oh God. And we're standing in your presence, God. For you are omnipresent, oh God. Father, we don't have to ask for you to come because you're already here, oh God. And Lord God, you are on the inside of us, oh God. And Lord God, we call upon the Spirit of Christ that resides in us, oh God. And Lord God, that he would do his perfect work, oh God. And have his way, oh God. And let your will, oh God, be done in this earth realm, God. Father, we just glorify you, Lord God, for this place. This sanctuary, oh God, for our leaders, oh God. Continue, Lord God, to endue them with power. Continue to encourage them, oh God. Continue to anoint them afresh, oh God. And Lord God, as our hearts come together, oh God, in this one place, and we are on one accord, oh God. Father, we desire more than anything, oh God, that you would dwell with us, oh God. And Father, that we will remember, oh God, all that you have done and all that you are, oh God. For you are Abba, oh God. You are a provider, God. You are a very present help, oh God. And there's none like you in all the earth, oh God. And Lord God, I thank you, Lord God, for healing hearts on today, oh God. Anything that separates us from the worship experience, oh God. Father, that our minds would not be bogged with the things, oh God, of yesteryear. But Lord God, that we would move into this new realm, oh God, in this atmosphere that you have created, oh God. Lord God, I thank you for the worship that's in this place. I thank and praise you for the prophetic that's in this place, oh God. For the healing and the gifts, oh God. Father, we give you the glory. And all of God's people said, hallelujah! And amen. And amen. Hallelujah. We give God glory. We give him honor. And we praise him for his word. Amen. I'm still falling in love with the word. Amen. I'm seeing something new every day in it. Amen. And this is your opportunity to share a scripture on your heart. As our own elder would say, something might be down in your belly that's just bubbling up. And you have to share because it's so good. Amen. For the logos, the written word. Amen. So those of you that have a word for this hour, you can share it now. Amen. Especially the young people. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Philippians 4:13. I can do all things through Christ which strengthens me. I was using this scripture always to help me to pass the Constitution. And I passed the first one. Graduation is next Monday, not tomorrow, but next Monday at 10. I think, 109 East 53rd Street. Great Bethesda Ministry.
Because he maketh intercession for the saints according to the will of God. And we know that all things work together for good to them that love God, to them who are called according to his purpose. For whom he did foreknow, he also did predestinate to be conformed to the image of his son, that he might be the firstborn among many brethren. Moreover, whom he did predestinate, them he also called. And whom he called, them he also justified. And whom he justified, them he also glorified. I just want to read for your hearing Romans 8, 27 through 30. Lord, I bless you for the reading and hearing of his word.
Amen.
We thank God for those powerful words that were shared. Amen. I especially like Maneva's. She got the young people calling on the word. Amen. Amen. And that's an example, because when we fall short, God will stretch out in us if we let him. If we let him. Just yield to his spirit. Amen. So she's learning. Amen. So I bless God for that. And the word is powerful. And it works. Amen. Amen. We got to open up the testimony. I just thank God. I know that he has blessed you because you're all here. Amen. I thank God for even coming on my way. I just want to honor my leaders. Amen. If I ever skip that, please know it's not because I don't honor you, because I do. And I praise God for you. I honor the Lord. And I'm just so grateful for being here. And I've been pressing my way trying to make it to Sunday school. And it was such a blessed lesson. And I enjoyed it. And I enjoyed our teacher on today. And so every time that we have and every opportunity to be under the word, we should take it. Not even take it for granted, because we probably read it from back to forth and we heard every lesson there is to be taught. But there's always something new in store for us. So I thank God for that. And I had the blessed opportunity of seeing my sister affirm a wedding on yesterday. Amen. And it was so awesome. It was so awesome. And I ate so that I probably need to lay on the altar on today, because I ate more than I should have taken in. But I thank God, because it taught me something. And, you know, I went to support Elder Johnson, but it's a challenge. I'm not a social person, but to be in places and you don't know the bride and groom, and it's like, oh, Lord, here we go. Baby, I was waiting for that chicken at the table. And indeed, I was like, oh, where'd you always have chicken? Because it's the least expensive thing that you can get. And I was hungry. The chicken came. The steak came. The ground turkey came. And then the guacamole came. The lettuce came. The salsa came. It was tacos. All you can eat. With nacho chips, soft shells, and hard shells. Yeah, green beans, potatoes, you name it. And I tell you, I was so happy. And y'all know I suffer from hangry. I was so, so happy. And I was like, this was a good idea. Because all the chips, so you know, I'm just saying, don't be surprised if you see taco at your table when I do something, because it was just so practical. And I had a good time, and I enjoyed myself, and I thank God for the invitation. And you know, it reminds me of our elder, and she said, just show up. Elder McClendon, just show up. Just show up. Even if you might not think something will come out of it, just show up, because you never know. And I showed up. And I was blessed. I needed an Uber. But I had to drive and trust God. Amen. I mean, man, amen. And your testimony, just some goodness of the Lord. And we often say, it ain't nothing big, but anything God does is big. Anything. And we're the one that put those measurements on them. And so for me, that was a big thing that happened on yesterday. Amen. So I bless God. Will there be
a testimony in the house.
I'm just a beautiful time, and I thank God. You know, I don't know what God is doing, having me doing weddings, and I might be doing another one, but we'll see what happens. I don't know what God's doing, but to God be the glory. Whatever His will is, that's what it will be. I'm just glad to be here, glad to be used by God in any way, shape, form, or fashion, because when God brings you through something, saints, when God brings you through something, you know that God is real. Pray for me as I pray.
Amen.
I still have joy. I still have joy. Out of all the things I've been through, I still have joy. I still have joy. I still have joy. Out of all the things I've been through, I still have joy. I still have joy. I still have joy. Out of all the things I've been through, I still have joy. There were times in my life when I felt that I couldn't go on. The Lord blessed me. He made me strong. I kept the faith. I held on through the night. This is my testimony. He made everything all right. Hallelujah. I still have joy. Out of all the things I've been through, I still have joy. I still have joy. I still have joy. Out of all the things I've been through, I still have joy. Hallelujah, church. Come on and praise Him in this place today. Amen. Hallelujah. Bless His name in this place today. Hallelujah. First, giving honor to God, giving honor to our apostle, Cleveland Person, to all the prophets, to all the saints. It's just a blessing to be in the house of the Lord one more time. And that's truly my testimony. I still have joy, no matter what and where I've been through. Through the storms, through every trial, and through every tribulation. I thank God for bringing us through. So I thank God for just being here today. For every other place that I'd rather be today than here in the house of the Lord. And I thank God for the service in here yesterday, the women's service, the hat service. And I just thank God because I sit and came in with expectation for the word, and I had a great time. But you know, God always does something strange. After the woman of God has spoken, they came over to me, Apostle, will you come on and get up? I said, wait a minute now. I don't like coming behind when there's a speaker in the house. And I said, told them, I don't want to be out of order. They said, well, Apostle, just would you please just come up for a few minutes. And the Lord blessed, we all had an altar call. And the women began, got up to sing. And got up, because you ever have an audience, they have an expectation. But you know when the enemy has a bound and they sing and they won't move. And I saw that in the house yesterday. Yeah, I don't care who was up here preaching, what was saying. The people was like bound. But when we got a breakthrough finally on yesterday, and people began to come up and be delivered, but yet there was still some that was bound. And the apostle got back up and she said, I'm speaking. I know there's some that came to seek God, but yet they still sit in their seat. But after the service, there was a line following me. You know what? I said, you quenched the spirit. You didn't move when the spirit was moving. And one lady said, I was just saying that I didn't want you to call on me. I said, God answered your prayer.
Come on, come on, Dad. Come on, come on.
He didn't give it to me to call on you. I said, it was an atmosphere when it's time. Sometimes saints sit down and they wait and look at others. But when you have something pressing before you and you need to reach out to God, it is your time to forget about how you look, who's in the place. It is time for us to press on to get what God has for us. And I just didn't understand it. So I told them they were lining up. I said, no, this is not an after service, but I will pray for you. And I thank God for the move for the women coming in, but I thank God for that breakthrough on yesterday. It's too much going on. The people are crying out. If the people in the church are still coming in with their heads hanging out, what kind of a testimony did we have to give the people? I thank God for Prophetess Monica with that testimony on today for how God healed her body, touched her body. And I know what it is to be going through being sick. I know what it is when they told me I had tuberculosis and when the doctors came and said, your body healed yourself. Now, I know that my body didn't heal myself. Nobody but God. Amen. So I just thank God for here. I thank God. Let's get into the service. I'm like this. I just come in with a praise party today.
Come on.
I'm not looking at who's not here, but I said, get into the service. I know it's raining, but see, when it's raining on Monday, we make our way to those jobs. Whatever it is, let's get into the service and let's have a praise party.
Amen.
Amen. First of all, I'd like to give an honor to the Lord and to the apostles here. And if they would allow me just to sing this little portion of this song, because it was worship. I want you to know that it was worship, being prostrated, laying out before God, that brought me through this. That deep seek.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let us worship Christ, our Savior.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Let us worship Christ, our Savior.
Yes, yes.
Oh, let us worship Him. King of glory. Hallelujah. Oh, let us bow before the King of glory. Oh, let us worship Him, our Lord and Savior. For He's a healer. Savior. Hallelujah. The word says, let them worship Him in spirit and in truth.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Thank you.
I just wanted to worship with Him a minute because He's so good.
Yes.
Hallelujah. That place of worship.
Yes.
Laying out before God.
Yes.
Hallelujah. He told me that cancer was not the answer, but that He had cancer. That He had a seed that sits above the sea of faith.
Yes.
Hallelujah, that I can trust Him. Oh, I worship Him today. Oh, I worship because He's good, because He's holy, and because He's right. Hallelujah.
Glory.
Oh, glory be to you, God. So let us worship Christ, our Savior. Oh, Lord, we welcome You in this place.
Yes.
Hallelujah, to manifest Your Shekinah glory.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Glory to You, God.
Yes.
Thank You, Lord.
Yes.
Hey!
Yes.
Thank You, God.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Thank You, God.
Yes.
Thank You for Your shifting.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hey, come your my feet. Come your shut on my feet. Oh. Hallelujah, God.
Yes.
Hallelujah. You're going to have to take the hinges off because they're coming.
Yes.
The worshipers are coming.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Glory, glory, glory. Glory, hallelujah. So let's worship. He's here in the fullness of His glory. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. I just wish you all would kind of take a moment and just do this. Because we want to receive that word. How many times have we heard that? Amen. I want you to get it in your mind. The worshipers are coming through the door. I want you to receive this and know this to be your truth. God delivered another prophet into the house to release a true word. But if we would just position ourselves to receive it fully, that our leaders would be blessed, that some of the weight would be lifted, and that we would go another place in the Lord and enter another realm. Hallelujah. It's not just for us, but those souls that are coming. Hallelujah. And let us worship Him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I thank God for that word. I thank God for what He's done. I thank God for the atmosphere and the shifting and the crescendo. Hallelujah. If we could just stay there, amen, because we're going to continue with worship. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
In the Lord with all thy heart. And lean not to thy own understanding.
Give God a praise. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We come to give Him praise.
some stuff in this house.
Amen.
Take the glory out.
Thank you. are welcome, oh God. Have your way in this house today. Rule by your spirit. Forever, forever, oh God. Thank you. Mahaka, Nishika, Hadro Shikiha, Chikibo, Haha, Tikaha, Pukomara, Haya, Shikipo, Uroshika, Hakamarashi, man of God, stand your ground, stand in your place, stand what God has called you to. That's the thing God's going to pull you into. He's going to pull you into your wealthy place. He's going to begin to pull you into your authority. Don't give up your place because of the world system. God wants to bring you into your place. And God's going to pull you out the dry place. He's going to begin to put you in a place where you can grow. He's going to begin to do things that God called you to. Don't worry about what they say or what they're doing to you. Do what God told you to do. God is going to do it. He's going to give you the good. He said, seek the things of Him first, and He will add the stuff to you already. You already got it. It's there in the spirit realm. Now it's going to come into the natural. And woman of God, rest. Rest your mind. God got you. God has you. He already heard you. He already heard what you've been saying to Him. He already heard what you put before Him about Him. Ha ha ha, yeah, yeah. It's already done. And don't stress yourself about it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
River that's flowing in this house. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And it was overflowing today. And it's not done yet. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You're all in the right place. Amen. Amen. Thank God that we have worshiped together. Amen. In spirit and in truth.
Even unto the great river, the river Euphrates, all the land of the Hittites, and unto the great sea toward the going down of the sun, shall be your coast. There shall not any man be able to stand before thee all the days of thy life. As I was with Moses, so I will be with thee. I will not fail thee nor forsake thee. Be strong and of a good courage, for unto this people shall thou divide for an inheritance the land, which I swear unto their fathers to give them. Only be thou strong and very courageous, that thou mayest observe to do according to all the law, which Moses my servant commanded thee. Turn not from it to the right hand or to the left, that thou mayest prosper with whithersoever thou goest. This book of the law shall not depart out of thy mouth, but thou shalt meditate therein day and night, that thou mayest observe to do according to all that is written therein. For then thou shalt make thy way prosperous, and then thou shalt have good success. Just want to talk a few minutes from the text. Amen. The text, the fifth verse. There shall not any man be able to stand before thee all the days of thy life. As I was with Moses, so I will be with thee. I will not fail thee nor forsake thee. Amen. Just look at a neighbor and say, neighbor, God has made a promise. Will you receive it? In Jesus' name. Amen. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. See, some you got to do more than just read it for Joshua. But you got to take this thing for yourself.
Yes.
Am I right about it?
Yes.
Amen. God has no respect of persons. Amen. And God sent me by here to tell somebody, amen, that God will never leave you nor forsake you. No matter what man has said, no matter what it looked like, no matter what you've been through, no matter how long you've been going through it. Amen. God told me to tell you, praise God, as he was with Moses, now Joshua is second in command. And he made promises to Joshua as he did to Moses. Amen. Sometimes you can be with people so long that all you see is that person. But sometimes you got to have experience for yourself to know who God is for you. Not through the eyes of somebody else, but through your own experiences with the Lord. Can I get a witness here? Amen. Moses was a great leader. All of us know that. Amen. Moses was the one that God chosen to go down to Egypt to tell Pharaoh to let my people go. And Joshua had his part to play, but he was playing second because Moses was first. Amen. Praise God. But now it's time for us. Somebody say us. Amen. It's time for us to come to the front line and not be scared to be used of God. But the Bible says that we have to be courageous. Am I right about it? Amen. Because now, look at a neighbor and say, now, neighbor, is your time and is your turn. Don't be scared. Say, is your time and is your turn. Say it again. Is your time and is your turn. Is your turn. Moses. Bible says, now, after the death of Moses, Moses' time was up. God called Moses off the scene. Moses had completed his assignment on earth. He has completed the mission that God called him to. Y'all remember when he was in Midian and he went up on the backside of the mountain and he came up to the mountain and he began to walk and God said, stop right there. Take off your shoes. For the ground that you're standing on is holy ground. And Moses just had to bow himself before that burning bush. As God began to speak to Moses out of the burning bush, and Moses got curious to know, how could this bush burn and not be consumed? He said, I'm going to turn and go and see for myself why it's not being consumed. God is not going to let you see everything. Something, child of God, you just have to trust God and take him at his word. That's what you call faith. Somebody needs to just gird up themselves and step out on faith. Hebrews 11:1 says, now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. And so sometimes we just have to need God out of faith. Tears would get his attention. But it's faith that moves the hand of God. So Moses, he said, I'm going to see this thing. But it was to him to go behind. He was just supposed to stay and be obedient and hear the voice of God. But the Bible says, those that have an ear, let them hear what the Spirit is saying to the church. Cornerstone, this building was not ours years ago. We stepped out on nothing. And God started to make the way ever since September of 1994. Sometimes God has to give you a tent ministry.
Come on.
As he did the children of Israel out in the wilderness. We eat it up. Help me, Holy Ghost. At Joshua's hall. What a coincidence. hallelujah, in 1994, took us to another place, 62nd and Damon. The devil reared his head, and we had to move out of there into one of the members' basement for church. Are you listening to me? Then we had to leave there, amen, and we ended up in our backyard. Oh my God. Going to show you how faith works and how sometimes you just have to trust God every step of the way. Sometimes we get so comfortable with somebody else walking in front and we walking in their footsteps. But every now and then, God will, he have to remove you and put you into another place where now you're not walking in that person's footsteps. You're walking in the footsteps of God for yourself. Amen. So you can see it firsthand at grassroots level. Yes. Some of us, we don't want that pioneer spirit. It takes some work down there with the grassroots. Yeah. You got to be willing to go through. Yeah. Let me finish this story so I can close. But as we went from the backyard, we was blessed with a place on 115th, right off of Michigan, 115th in Kensington, block south of 115th Street. Uh-huh. And then we stayed there for a while, and that place, it wasn't bigger than our foyer back there. But we had church. We loved it. In the summertime, we sweated. See, somebody, I heard a preacher say, you see the glory, but you don't know the story. So we was there sweating, praising God, praising him outside, praising him in the basement. We gave God, as my wife say, a crazy, ridiculous favor praise. We praised him in advance until we kept going through the rain, through the sunshine, through heartache, through pain, through splits. People go on their own ways, but we are still here. God can do it with a many, or he can do it with a few. Come on here, Gideon. Tell him to reduce the army because he got too many. They already had less than the enemy. He said, you still got too many. Because God wants to get the glory. Yes. Hallelujah, somebody. God wants to get the glory. Sometimes we wonder why we're going through things. Because God, he's making, he's shaping, he's molding you the way he wants you to be. He wanted you to get rid of all your ideologies and what you think. The gospel is not about us. The gospel is about Jesus Christ. That he able to save the lost. Hallelujah. And the blood still works. And there's nothing too hard for God. And whatever you come up against, God always has a ram in the bush. Am I right about it? But God want to know, do you love him? If you love him enough, you got to know that all things work together for the good to them that love him and are called according to his purpose. He want to see if you really, if he can trust you or not. Do you really love him or not? Moses had a big old knife after Isaac was laying on the altar. Abraham, thank you, had a big old knife as Isaac was laying on the altar, getting ready to cut his throat. Y'all know about pulling them knives out. Come on here. Getting ready to cut his throat. And God called out of heaven, Abraham, stay right here. Now I know you love me. Say, look over there. It's a lamb caught ram caught in the thicket, in the bush. Get him. As we continue, Bible says, second verse, Moses, my servant, is dead. Now, therefore, arise and go over this Jordan, thou and all this people, unto the land which I do give to them, even to the children of Israel. God always have a man or woman that's going to continue the work that he has begun. Because the good work that he has begun in you, he's going to finish it. Hallelujah. And the word that God sent out, it won't return unto him void, but it will accomplish what he sent it out to do. So Moses is gone now, and now it's time for Joshua to continue to lead the children of Israel to that place where he had promised Moses. One thing about God, he's not slack concerning his promises. If God said it, he'll do it. If he spoke it, it shall come to pass. And the Bible says, every place that the sole of your foot shall tread upon, that have I given unto you. As I said unto Moses, don't you know that it is a continuation? We got to do more than come into the house of God and sit on the premises. But we got to stand on his promises. Can I get a witness here? And the Bible says, wherever the sole of your foot shall tread upon, that have I given unto you, as I said unto Moses. And I know the promises that God has made to Cornerstone. And I know the promises that he has made to you. I just stopped right here and ask you, have you forgot the promises that God has placed down in your spirit? If the thing that God has placed in your spirit, praise God, God said it's time to stir it up. And then stir up that gift that he has placed in you. Because your gift will, hey, hallelujah, it will go before you. It will bring you before great men. It will make room for you and bring you before great men. I just stop here to tell you that God's promises is still sure. God's promises is still activated. God promises is still alive. All we got to do is just step out on faith today, church. As he said to Joshua, amen, he talked to Moses, now he's talking to Joshua. He talked to Joshua, now he's talking to the church today. All we have to do is step out on the word of God. He said, wherever the sole of your feet shall tread upon, he's going to give it to you. And I think about the prophetess here. After we came in this place, y'all don't hear me, and we still started walking around the walls of Jericho, and we started laying hands on this place. We didn't, y'all don't hear me. We didn't have the money, but we had the faith. Hallelujah. We didn't have the material. Amen. But we had the belief that God was going to do it. And we started laying hands on this place. Walking around in this place. Somebody needs to walk around in their faith today. What you believe in God for. What you trust in God for. What you pray to God for. What you're fasting for. What you believe in him for. You need to walk around and just claim it in Jesus' name. Because he is no respecter of persons, and he's no shorter than his words. Hallelujah. What you need, God's got it. What you need, God got it. He's got everything that you need. Glory be to God. I'm almost done here. I'm about to close. than the Bible says. Yes. What the soil of your foot shall tread upon, that have I given unto you. Yes. As I said unto Moses. Yes. Uh-huh. Sometimes, saints, thou shalt when you get it. Shout before you get there. Shout in advance. Praise in advance. Give him the glory in advance. Because he already done it. He said, as I said unto Moses, from the wilderness, amen. It wasn't dead and void because Moses was off the scene. Sometimes we think because certain people is not there, that is dead and void. It's going to be live and well, whether you are in Illinois, whether you are in Texas, whether you are in California, whether you are in Hawaii, it's still alive. Hallelujah. God just wants our obedience from the wilderness of this Lebanon, even unto the great river, the river Euphrates. All the land of the Hittites. Gonna take all that land. Sometimes the places that you see, it just may be yours. When they went into the land of Canaan, the folks were still there. The Hittites, the Perizzites, the Jebusites, they were still on the land. But Joshua and his army had to go in. See, we don't want to work. We want stuff given to us. But you got to roll up your sleeves, make up your mind, put on your spiritual armor, your helmet, your sword of the spirit, your breastplate, your loins girded with truth, your feet shod with the preparation of peace. He didn't give you no back armor. Because he didn't expect for you to be a coward. Come on. He didn't expect for you to be scared. Yeah. He said, unto the great river, to the great sea, toward the going down of the sun shall be your coat. And this is the verse. There shall not any man.
Come on.
You don't have to fear any man.
Come on.
You don't have to fear any spirit. Yeah. The prophet is saying in spiritual warfare, face your demons. Face them. David was a young teenager. He had to face representation somebody of a demon, the giant Goliath. Sometimes you may be facing things that are bigger than you. But God told me to tell you, it's your time and it's your turn. Sometimes you have to run through troops and leap over walls. Sometimes you may have to go through the giants. You can pray and the mountains will be cast into the sea according to the word of God. Whatever standing in your way and what God has for you, it's got to lay down because you're more than a conqueror in Christ Jesus. Y'all give me a minute. I'm almost there. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It says, no man. Think about it. No, not any man be able to stand before you all the days of your life. Didn't it happen? Amen. Joshua was victorious in the children of Israel and the army of Israel because of the anointing that was upon him. When you have anointing upon your life, that makes the difference. When the Holy Ghost is working on the inside of you, releasing the power of God, amen. Nothing is impossible for you to conquer because God said we are more than conquerors. Bible says, as I was with Moses, so will I be with thee. As he was with Moses, as he was with Joshua, he's with us. And sometimes we have to take this word personally when you're going through. when you're trying to start up something, when you're trying to get something off the ground, when other people don't understand how you're going to do it, you don't have the money, you don't have the backing, but favor gets you places that money will not. Are you listening to me? All we have to do is trust in God, amen, and start walking like it's already there. Start walking to that thing. Start speaking and declaring that thing in Jesus' name. Speak those things as not, as though they were. See yourself in the spirit. We sing a song around here, I can see it in the spirit. It's coming down. I believe it in the spirit. It's coming down. Riches is coming down in the spirit. Hallelujah. The things you need is coming down in the spirit. You got to believe it. The Bible says, these signs shall follow them that believe. God want to use some of us as being pioneers. He wants to show the world that he is able to do exceedingly, abundantly, above all we can ask or think, according to the power that working in you. Ephesians 3:20. He want to do it. God said it's your time. It is your turn. If you got the faith, God's got the power. If you got the determination, God's got the power. Yeah. If you stand on his word, God's got the power. Wow. You ain't just reading these scriptures just to be reading them, but you ought to take them in your heart.
Yeah.
David said, thy word have I hid in my heart that I may not sin against thee. And that's what separates you from your blessing, is that sin. But we have to clear up. Hallelujah. And walk in the vocation whereby we've been called. Amen. Give the Lord a hand, praise. Be strong in the Lord. Be strong and of a good courage. For unto this people shall thou divide for inheritance the land, which I swear unto their fathers to give them. Even though it was a lot that they had to go through, it was a lot of rebellion, it was a lot of stiff-neckedness, it was a lot of adultery and everything, but God had to keep his word. Why? Because he swore by it. Sometimes God chastises us when we get off track and we're doing wrong. But God didn't make no jump. You are a masterpiece in God's hand. And God has something special just for you. 7 verse says, only be thou strong and very courageous, that thou mayest observe to do according to all the law which Moses my servant commanded thee. We already got the blueprint and a roadmap to travel. All we have to do is stay with it. There's a lot of religious on the scene. There's a lot of cultish things on the scene. We got to stay with the word. What do the word say about it? If you stay with the Lord, he's certainly going to stay with you. Because if the Lord is not with you, the Lord didn't move. Man do the move. God is always, he's where he's always been. He said, turn not from it to the right hand or to the left, that thou mayest prosper whithersoever thou goest. This book of the law shall not depart out of thy mouth, but thou shalt meditate therein day and night, that thou mayest observe to do according to all that is written therein. For then thou shalt make thy way prosperous, and then thou shalt have good success. God want us to be successful. God wants us to be prosperous. God wants us to be victorious. And we can be all those things that we trust in and never die. Hallelujah. We're going to get up. We're going to extend an invitation. Maybe someone don't know the Lord in the pardon of their sins. Even for the unseen guests, we thank God for our guests, the prophet and the prophetess today. But for the unseen guests, and for those that God is stirring up in the spirit to come to this place, we have our arms open. The Spirit is welcoming you in the name of Jesus.
To cross over. This side of Jordan was their past. And as they crossed over, they were going into their future. See, in the past was nothing but wilderness and dry places. And when God gets us to that point, that a lot of us is just one step away from our blessing, crossing over our spiritual joy. And when we cross over, we have to leave that past behind us. And as they step over, they had to die to the old in order to receive the new. And I thank God that when they was prepared, they had to go around that mountain 40 years for God to work something out of them. And he worked it out of them that they had to die to the old things. Even some of them had to die off because of unbelief. But I'm here, I just wanted to add to that, we are one step away from our blessing right now. We are one step away from our spiritual joy. Some of us been in dry places. Some of us look like nothing begin to prosper. Look like we've been going through around and around, but I hear the Spirit saying, you coming up out of your dry place. And you going into the land of milk and honey, the land of blessing. Hallelujah. I hear the Spirit said it's yours. He said, if you want to stay back there, you will be in your wilderness, but God wants to bring you to a land of plenty.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Yeah. As the apostle was speaking, it was resonating in my spirit that this is a time. It's time to hang up everything that has pulled us back on that side of Jordan.
Yeah. Yeah.
We need to die to a lot of things in order to cross over. And sometimes crossing over, hallelujah, then it's a time of preparation of going in and taking it by force. When they went over crooks and the people that was in that place, hallelujah, they had to take it by force. They were there as a placeholder. They were the zero, but God brought them in to take it by force. Some of us want God just to hand it to us, but God has given it to us and we got to take it by force. For the Bible said, heaven suffered violence, and violence taken by force. Amen.
Amen. Praise God. Thank God for the icing on the cake.
Yeah.
Amen. If there being all, thank God for the prophet. You have something you'd like to say, prophet? Prophet is again.
Prophet Greg.
Prophet Greg. Prophet Greg, amen.
Amen. Amen.
Praise God, Apostle. Praise God, Apostle. Just be encouraged, and I thank you, man of God, for God using you. And I bless God for you. Woman of God, what more could I say? The Spirit used you. Because I don't leave my wife with nobody. So when I walked away from you, that told you I was okay with you.
All right. Amen.
Never would I leave her with nobody. And woman of God, God got so many things in store for you.
Hallelujah.
He got so many things in store for you. He said, come on. And to that woman of God behind you, God said, if you give it to him, he'll fix it.
Yes. Bless God. Amen.
He said, you're carrying something that you shouldn't. And I thank you, Apostle and Prophetess, for you guys allowing us to come and partake in the Lord's Word with you.
Amen. This is totally a blessing. This is actually a confirmation that you spoke. We heard Bishop Paul Morton spoke the same thing at Apostolic
Church of God.
Church of God. Same word, same script. She came from the same scripture that the walls of Jericho are coming down. It's time for us to go in and take it by force. But even as you were standing there, I couldn't hear you talk. I could hear God speaking a prophetic word to his people. This was not just a service. God himself came down like he did in Psalms 18, and he came down to see about his people, and he spoke a rhema word to his people. And surely if we take it by force and take captive that word that he spoke, we're going to receive the portion of what he spoke. We're going to receive the word.
Yeah.
It's a faith thing now.
Yeah.
It's not about what you see. It's about a knowing in the word of God. It's about a sureness that you have in God.
Yes, God.
Hallelujah, because we're standing up against some things. Yeah. I mean, there's still some health challenges there. But I don't see the challenge. I see Jesus. And if I said, God, if you don't do it, then it won't be done. But I got enough faith, God, to believe that you're able. So I stay in the fire. stay with you and Jesus until you deliver.
Yeah.
We receive that word on today. The Lord said you're not going to have to open the doors. Mm. We're in a time and in a dispensation where he's going to have to take the hinges off because the droves, they're coming in. Wow. They're coming in, and this is a ready people that have been prepared. They've gone through the process. They don't look like us. And they may look like a generation that want to be overlooked, but he said, "What he said, Gideon army, the ones that knew how to get down and lap like a dog."
Yeah.
He said, "They're coming in. They've been dogged out, dumped and thrown on. They've been talked about, trampled over." He said, "But they've been a faithful people that have known how to call on the name of Jesus, and they're coming in. 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 God said they're coming in this place because the raw, unadulterated truth is being taught here in this temple, in this sanctuary. Hallelujah. They're coming in. The gangbangers coming in. The whoremongers coming in. Hallelujah. The drug dealers are coming in. The adulterers are coming in. The fornicators are coming in. Because they're coming in with the spirit of what is that? The seven sons of Skeet. Hallelujah. They done did some inspection.
Yeah.
And they know where the real word is being preached. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yeah. They're coming in because they know where the real power of God is being released.
Yeah.
They're coming in, said God.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. He said, people, position yourself and make yourself ready. Because if you're not in position, the apostle will have to replace you. Because there's a people that's coming in, and these people are ready to serve God. Hallelujah. It's your time. You right? You preach to yourself. And it's your turn. Hallelujah. It's your turn. And it's your turn.
Glory
to God. No more delay. No more hinder. No more hold up. No more setback. Hallelujah. But God has stepped in.
Agree with me, we are all a part of God's body.
for you. You pray for me. I love you. I need you, Jesus. I hold on you. We heard from my mouth. I love you. I need you to survive. It is His will that indeed we supply. You are important to me. I need you to survive. Our Father God, which art in heaven, we come before your almighty throne of grace. At this hour, once again, to say thank you. We thank you, Lord God, for sitting high and looking low. We thank you, Lord God, for giving us visitation in this service on today. We thank you, Lord God, for every spoken word that was spoken in your name. Father God, we thank you for the prophetic word. We just thank you for your Shekinah glory. God, we pray for each and every one under the sound of our voice. We pray for those that didn't make it out today. We pray for them wherever they are. Father God, we pray that you can give us strength and grace as we prepare to leave this place. Remember the sick, the suffering, the shattered, bereaved families, everywhere, each and every church home is open in your almighty name. God, remember the fivefold ministry today in the name of Jesus. God, we pray for those in the leadership and authority everywhere, oh God. We thank the Lord because you sit high and you look low. Oh God, we thank you because your eyes are going to and fro on the earth. Oh, Father God, we thank you, Lord God, for being who you are. And we thank you for what you are to us, oh God, each and every day. Pray that you cover us with your blood. Oh, God, bless each and every home in the name of Jesus. Bless the marriages and bless the singles in the name of Jesus. Now may the grace of God and the sweet communion of the Holy Spirit rest rooted and abide with thee from henceforth and forevermore. Let's all sing together. Ah.